In this lesson, we will discuss the difference between passing by reference and passing by value. In the past, when we have called subprocedures, we have run the risk of accidentally overriding the values of the variables in the calling statement argument list. In this program, a subprocedure named changeval is called, and the variables A, B, C, and D are linked with the variables W, X, Y, and Z in changeval. If the values of W, X, Y, or Z are altered in changeval, this will alter the values in A, B, C, and D in main. When we run this code, three message boxes appear. The first message box states, before changeval 1, 2, 3, 4. The second message box states, in changeval 1, 2, 3, 4. And the third message box states, after changeval 50, 55, 60, 65. Let's examine why these values appear. In main, four double variables named A, B, C, and D are created and given a double data type. A is assigned the value 1, B is assigned the value 2, C is assigned the value 3, and D is assigned the value 4. A message box appears that displays the text before changeval, then the value of A, the value of B, the value of C, and the value of D. The values of these four variables are 1, 2, 3, and 4. Next, the subprocedure changeval is called. This subprocedure has four arguments, A, B, C, and D. The variable A in main is linked with the variable W in changeval. The variable B in main is linked with the variable X in changeval. The variable C in main is linked with the variable Y in changeval. And the variable D in main is linked with the variable Z in changeval. The variables W, X, Y, and Z in changeval are automatically declared and given the same data type as A, B, C, and D in main, which is double. The values of W, X, Y, and Z in changeval are initialized to the values of A, B, C, and D in main. So W starts with the value 1, X starts with the value 2, Y starts with the value 3, and Z starts with the value 4. Next, a message box appears that states, in changeval and the values of W, X, Y, and Z, which are 1, 2, 3, and 4. Next, W is assigned the value 50, X is assigned the value 55, Y is assigned the value 60, and Z is assigned the value 65. The subprocedure changeval ends with the end sub statement, and we return to main. The variables W, X, Y, and Z in changeval were all altered, and this will change the values of A, B, C, and D in main. The variable A in main has the same value as the variable W in changeval, which is 50. The variable B in main has the same value as the variable X in changeval, which is 55. The variable C in main has the same value as the variable Y in changeval, which is 60. And the variable D in main has the same value as the variable Z in changeval, which is 65. After the subprocedure changeval is terminated, the variables W, X, Y, and Z in changeval also are terminated. The third and final message box appears that states, after changeval, the value of A, B, C, and D, which are now 50, 55, 60, and 65. We can see in this example that the subprocedure changeval alters the values of the variables in the calling statement argument list. The values of A, B, C, and D change from 1, 2, 3, and 4 before the subprocedure is called to 50, 55, 60, and 65 after the sub-procedure is terminated. This occurs because we are actually passing the memory addresses of the variables A, B, C, and D in main to the variables W, X, Y, and Z in changeval. Both A in main and W in changeval refer to the same location in memory. If W is modified in changeval, this is equivalent to modifying A in main, since you are modifying the same location in memory. Similarly, both B in main and X in changeval refer to the same location in memory. C in main and Y in changeval refer to the same location in memory. And D in main and Z in changeval refer to the same location in memory. This process is called passing by reference. Sometimes you want to pass only the values of the arguments to the subprocedure and not allow the arguments to be updated after the subprocedure is terminated. This process is called passing by value and can be accomplished by placing parentheses around the arguments in the calling statement argument list. Let's place parentheses around A and C. And rerun the code. Again, three message boxes appear. The first message box states before changeval 1, 2, 3, 4. The second message box states in changeval 1, 2, 3, 4. And the third message box states after changeval 1, 55, 3, 65. Let's see why this occurs. The first message box will state before changeval and the values of A, B, C, and D. These variables are initially assigned the values 1, 2, 3, and 4. Now we call changeval. Only the values of A and C in main are passed to the variables W and Y in changeval. If the values of W and Y in changeval are updated, this will not affect the values of A and C. However, if the values of X and Z in changeval are updated inside changeval, this will affect the values of B and D in main because there are not parentheses around them. Passing by value allows information to flow in one direction only, from main to changeval, but not back up to main when changeval ends. Inside changeval, the variables W, X, Y, and Z are created and initialized to the values of A, B, C, and D in main, which are 1, 2, 3, and 4. The second message box will state in changeval, and the values of W, X, Y, and Z in changeval, which we have just seen, are 1, 2, 3, and 4. Next, the variables W, X, Y, and Z are assigned new values, 50, 55, 60, and 65. And the sub-procedure changeval is terminated with the end sub-statement. Now we will return to main. Although W and Y have been updated in changeval, these changes will not be passed back up to A and C in main. A and C will retain the values of 1 and 3. X and Z in changeval have been updated to 55 and 65, and these changes will be passed up to B and D in main. The third message box states after changeval and the values of A, B, C, and D in main, which are 1, 55, 3, and 65. In summary, if you do not place parentheses around an argument in the calling statement argument list, you are passing by reference. When you pass by reference, you allow the sub-procedure to modify the arguments. If you place parentheses around an argument in the calling statement argument list, you are passing by value. When you pass by value, you protect the argument from being modified when the subprocedure is terminated.